inside and sit down.
Hi. Welcome to the mystery tour. Relax. Plenty more locked doors where we're going. And people to push you around.
You stand on the line and you over there. Your name is Catherine Elaine Peterson?
Yes.
You have been charged and convicted of murder. You've been sentenced to 15 years jail to serve a minimum of 12, is that correct?
Yes.
Right, go to the counter, remove all jewelry and your watch. Officer Perry will take your belongings and you'll sign for them.
You know, sometimes when I close my eyes, I can see my son.
What's his name?
Jerry. He's 3. I've loved 2 people in my life and I've lost both of them.
The bloke you killed?
No. That was Conrad. I'm talking about my husband, Jerry. He was killed in a car crash. I didn't think I could go on. And my baby was born and I just lived for him.
Then this Conrad turned up.
Yes. Oh, I suppose I wanted somebody to share things with. I was lonely. If only I'd known what he really was. When I knew for certain he was going to kill my little boy, what else could I have done?
I would have done the same. Any man that tries to kill a little kid like that doesn't deserve to live.
I know, but look at me now. I mean, what good has it done me?
Listen, Kate. It may sound like corny advice, but I've been around. And I know what a place like this can do to your mind. You've got to forget all that. We're in here for a long one. You might as well make the most of it.
Yes, I know. It's just hard to accept, that's all.
You'll make it. We start work in the laundry tomorrow. I reckon there'll be plenty to keep us busy.
Mrs. Smith, my name is Kate Peterson. I'm one of the new girls.
I know. What can I do for you?
Well, nothing much, really. It's just that I've heard quite a lot about you, and I understand you're fairly powerful where the prisoners are concerned. Well, I wanted to tell you a few facts about my background. I've heard about the famous prison grapevine and how facts can become distorted, so I've decided to tell you the truth about my baby so I can scotch any rumours before they start.
And am I the first to get this information, or have you already given it to the governor?
That's what I mean, you see. Rumours, distorted facts.
Then why did you go to the governor?
I wasn't lagging. But apart from that, I can't tell you any more. I'm a doctor. I must hold on to my professional ethics.
Well, we have certain ethics in here, too. Now, I suggest if you want us to know the truth about you and your baby, you speak up so we can all hear it.
No, it's my own private business. I was only telling you...
Kate, come on, they can't hear you clearly. Now, speak up.
What the hell are you doing in here?
I was looking for you.
Pinching stuff, more like it.
I don't do things like that.
Oh, yeah? Well, you could have seen from the door whether we were in here or not.
Look, I wish you'd believe me. I just came to talk to you.
What about?
Well, nothing in particular.
So you're poking around in our room just to chat about the weather, eh?
Well, I just wanted to avoid a fight like yesterday's.
Mm-hmm. Somebody send you?
No.
Now, you listen to me. You better watch your step, Doc, or you're liable to end up biting off more than you can chew.
I've got no quarrel with you two. In fact, we hardly know each other, so why fight? I mean, I've always been against fighting. It seems so unnecessary to hurt each other.
Really? I thought you were in for murder.
Well, I can explain about that.
What the hell do you reckon you're pushing around?
Stand up!
Oh, yeah!
You know, I'm too good, Kate. Maybe you should see a doctor.
something.
Let's eat.
Yeah. Kate!
Who got you, Brian? Anyone with her?
Yes.
Fat duck Dory.
I think the other one was called Hazel.
Do you believe me now? Do you understand about those slobs? Don't worry. We'll pay them back. But no more talking, okay? I told you before, they only understand one thing. So, are you with me or not?
Yes. You can count me in.
You're managing all right, then?
Of course I'm all right, Mother. I'm the model prisoner. Sweetness and light itself. Both to the authorities and the other prisoners. You needn't worry about me, Mother. I know how to handle people.
I hate to hear you being so cynical, Kate. You used to be such a sweet little girl. I don't know when you adopted this hard attitude.
You always thought I was so sweet simply because I knew how to handle you. If I'm cynical, it's your fault. It didn't take me long to learn that if I smiled prettily and I hugged you tightly enough, I could have almost anything I wanted.
That's a dreadful thing to say. Makes it sound as though you've gone through your whole life manipulating people.
One has to use what talent one possesses.
You had a great talent, Kate, as a doctor. Everyone admired you. I'll never understand how you got involved defrauding the government.
Because it was very lucrative. How many reasons do you want?
I still can't believe you actually killed a man.
I had to. He was going to report me. Poor Conrad. If only he could have seen things my way.
He loved you, Kate.
Well, not enough. He was a fool. Like the women in here are fools.
Anyway, we shouldn't be talking like this in front of Gerard. Do you know you've hardly spoken to him?
What's the point? He looks on you as his mother.
Well, is it any wonder? After all, I virtually brought him up.
Well, don't expect me to get maternal at this late stage. No point to it, is there? Not while I'm in here. But I shall have to play the distraught mum to the hilt when I'm testifying.
Is that all he means to you? A chance of acquittal?
Well, at least it's something, isn't it? Up to now, he's only been a nuisance.
You're not only cynical, Kate, you're...
If I'm shocking you, Mother, perhaps you'd better go. And don't feel you have to visit me often. I mean, we really don't have very much to say to each other, do we? Goodbye, Gerard. Hello, Lizzie. What sort of a day did you have?
Pretty bloody awful. Just wandering around. I saw you in the garden.
Oh, yes?
You were the woman and a little boy. Is he yours?
Yes, that's Gerard. I hated leaving him there.
Yeah, bloody hard, isn't it? Especially with children. I know how I used to feel when I used to see Josie go. She's my granddaughter, sort of.
Oh, yes?
Love kids, don't you?
Yes, yes, of course I do.
He's a very good-looking little bloke.
Yes, he takes after his father. He was very handsome.
You've had a rotten trot, haven't you? Losing your husband and ending up in here.
Yes, it hasn't been easy.
Yeah, being separated from your little kid. It's a lousy world. Shouldn't be allowed. Keeping a mother from a child.
For heaven's sake, Lizzie, do you have to go on about it?
Oh, that's how you feel. I don't know how I'd bother.
Lizzie, look, I'm sorry. Please don't go. It's just the strain of seeing Gerard for such a short while and then having to let him go so soon.
Yeah, I know. It's awful.
I really didn't mean to snap at you. It's just that I needed some time to pull myself together. I'm still upset.
I understand. I'll leave you on your own some for a while.
Thank you, Lizzie. You're very kind and understanding.
Stupid old fool.
Kate?
Yes?
I was going to give you that some other time, but there's no time like the present. It's for your little boy.
Lizzie, that's very thoughtful of you.
Oh, when I saw you in the garden with him, he looked so sad, the poor little bugger.
Yes, it hasn't been easy for him.
Do you like it? I made it myself.
Oh, it's very nice, Lizzie. Yes, I'm sure he'll love it.
Do you think he'll like the colours?
Oh, I'm sure he will. Thank you. You've gone to a lot of trouble.
Oh, that's all right. I enjoy keeping busy. Oh, I better go and I'll see you in the dining room.
Bye.
You ready, ladies?
I don't think she's going to eat that. Oh, what a cute little thing. Do you have any children?
Yes, a little boy of two.
Perhaps he'd like it.
Are you giving it away?
If you'd like it, yes.
Oh, but it's yours, isn't it?
Not really. Go on, take it.
Did you make it?
Hardly. I think I'm a little more creative than that.
Thanks very much. Denny loves surprises.
See you tomorrow.
Thanks again.
Hey, where'd you get that?
Cute, isn't it? Kate Peterson gave it to me. You know, it's a shame to see her in a place like this. She's so nice.
Yeah. Nice.
Well, I won't disturb you. I just came to collect the tray.
I hear your little boy came to see you. How is he?
Well, this whole business hasn't been very easy for him. I just hope he's not too affected by it all. Still, he seems quite happy when I see him. I do miss him.
What's his name?
Gerard, after his father.
Lizzie mentioned something about making a toy for him.
Yes, she made him a toy, but really, he's got so many already, and he hardly ever plays with them. He's a little spoilt, I think. So I gave it to Sister Franklin for her little boy. I hope Lizzie doesn't mind.
Kate, you want it in reception. You've got a visitor.
Good. It'd be nice to get some outside news. You won't tell Lizzie, will you? I'd hate to upset her.
No, I won't say a word.
Thank you.
Yes?
As your lawyer, I can't be expected to serve your interests unless you tell me everything. Appeals aren't to be taken lightly, nor are they easy.
I'm well aware of that. If it were easy, I wouldn't need you.
Have you been perfectly honest with me?
I'm not stupid, David. I wouldn't jeopardize my freedom by lying to you.
It's not so much a matter of lying as of not telling me everything.
You really do have the uncanny knack of making me very angry.
Look, all I'm doing is giving you a chance to tell me the whole truth.
David, you obviously have something on your mind, so would you stop this legal runaround and tell me what it is?
Well, I've discovered some rather interesting facts.
I hope you can put them to good use.
They may be best left well alone.
Go on.
In the course of my investigations, I came across your account books. And in particular, some rather large discrepancies.
And?
As you say, I'm your family lawyer. And my duty may be compromised by delving too deep. But if I did, I could well come up with the real reason you murdered your friend.
Is that a professional opinion?
No, it's a personal one.
Good. Well, let's keep it that way.
What are you doing? Powell's letter. She's getting really nervous about it. A sudden body search wouldn't surprise me.
So you really play it safe, don't you?
Just using my head. They've searched all the other cells. We're the only place left they can look.
I suppose so. I must admit, I wouldn't think of looking in there.
Well, you've got to know who and what you can use. That's the name of the game.
You always come out on top.
Would I be inside if I did? The odds are pretty good, though. Oh, I'm tired.
I suppose it'd be even worse tomorrow. Back to that lovely laundry. I hear the new laundry scheme's working quite well.
It is. See, that's what I mean. I may have to work for McNally's mob, but if I can get a little something out of it on the side, so what?
How can you work for McNally's lot in here?
Recruiting for his massage parlours. I didn't have much choice. My husband's in Pentridge, and I can get at him. It was a question of agreeing or agreeing if I ever wanted to see him in one piece again.
Isn't it a bit dicey trying to put one over on McNally's lot?
You could say that, yes. Boy, if only old Gracie knew.
Gracie?
Detective Inspector Grace. If he knew what I know about McNally, his brain would blow up.
You wouldn't tell him.
That'd be stupid. I like living. No. The name of the game is outmaneuvering. And if I do say so myself, I'm pretty good at it.
Sounds like a game worth playing.
Aren't you supposed to be in the dining room, Peterson?
I thought we might have a little chat first.
Why would I want to do that?
Oh, I don't know. I think we can, how shall I put it, be of service to each other. What are you on about? Well, I thought you might be interested in the whereabouts of a certain letter.
What do you know about it?
You could do me a favor in return.
Get to the point, will you? I'm supposed to be looking for Mrs. Morris. Now, if she shows up...
Oh, I see. And you wouldn't want to be in on this conversation. Well, I'll get to the point. You want a certain letter, and I know exactly where it is at this very moment.
Where?
Now, hold on a minute. I want a visit arranged, and I don't want any of the women to know anything about it. After it's arranged, I'll tell you everything I know. Who do you want to see? The visitor you want to see is coming in this morning.
Good. Well, come on, where is it? You're in a bit of a hurry, aren't you?
Look, you know we're supposed to be working in twos. Now, I can't keep finding excuses to get away on my own.
Relax! The letter isn't going to disappear. After I've had my visit, you can have the letter.
Oh, look, I've had a gut full of playing cat and mouse. Now, I want that letter and I want it now.
You know, you really shouldn't get so uptight about things.
It's bad for the system. Makes you sweat.
Still, a little talcum should take care of that.
Oh, if you've run out, I think there's some round here somewhere.
Inspector Grace, my name is Kate Peterson.
I understand you want to see me.
Yes, that's right. There are a few things I think we should discuss.
Well, it's a little unusual. Normally I'm the last person you lot want to talk to.
So I believe, but I've heard quite a lot about you in here.
I can imagine. Not exactly the most popular person, am I?
No, but I think you and I should get on very well.
All right. But we can dispose of the bullshit. Obviously, you've got something to talk to me about. Get to the point.
Well, I realize that getting information is one of your most difficult jobs. Now, I am in what might be called a position of confidence in here. I hear many things. Things that could be helpful to you.
I see. I gather you'd expect something in return. Perhaps you should take a seat. We'll get to know each other better.
I think that's an excellent idea. It concerns the McNally mob.
Go on.
I have information. Details of unsolved crimes, who's involved. Featuring one Mr. Fitzwater.
Fitzwater, eh?
And it's good information. Best you can buy.
Who said anything about buying?
I did. But not for money. I'm planning an appeal against my sentence. You're going to find me a witness.
It's bloody funny the way Powell's on top of everything these days.
What do you mean?
Well, she just happens to know where I hid that letter, and she just happens to turn up in the kitchen when Lizzie's there. It's almost as if she's been told.
You don't reckon someone lagged, do you?
Oh, surely not. It's possible. Look out, screws.
I'm not in the habit of scandalizing, but you and the other woman have a right to know for your own protection. Kate Peterson is the most amoral and devious person it's ever been my misfortune to meet.
Wow, that's pretty heavy stuff.
Well, you don't know her like I do. I can't prove it, but I think she was up to her neck in a health insurance fraud worth thousands. Conrad Benson suspected her, too. That's why she killed him. He was a good friend.
You know, you don't look like the sort of person who'd make a friend of a child, Basher. From what I heard, Benson deserved to die.
Conrad would have cut off his arm before he'd abuse a child. I've seen him work a 12-hour stint on urgent cases and then go straight to the recovery room to hold some kid's hand. He loved children.
Well, if what you say is true, Kate Peterson's a pretty nasty piece of work.
Thank you, Miss Conway. I'll handle things now. I'm sure you've got a lot to do.
Or perhaps we should stay. The new regulations...
I know what the regulations are. So please go, both of you. You and I have something to discuss.
Do we?
I do not intend to have the women plan any more trouble unless I know about it. From now on, you're going to be my eyes and ears. I want to know everything that's going on in here.
You want me to inform against the women?
In a nutshell, yes. Suppose I don't feel that's in my best interests. I mean, I do have my own future to protect.
Precisely. That's why you'll do exactly as I say. Otherwise, I could make it difficult for you to have any more visits.
All right. Let's compromise. I'll tell you anything I think is important, but you must let me decide when and how. I can't keep running to you with little things that happen. Sooner or later, the women will find out, and we both know what they'll do to me. And I have no intentions of leaving Wentworth any other way but under my own steam.
I don't think you're in any position to dictate terms. You're worried about your health now? Imagine what the women would do if they found out about your little meetings with Grace. Oh, I could also let slip some information you've already passed on. I'm sure they'd be very interested.
I don't think you'd do that, Mrs. Powell. See, it wouldn't be sensible. I'm sure Inspector Grace, with all his contacts, could get back that letter you wrote to the newspapers. Well, if your name were to come out, that would be the end of you at Wentworth. Most unfortunate.
Look, I just don't understand your angle. What's in it for you? All this little Miss Innocent sweetness and light floating down the corridors. It just doesn't ring true.
Why won't you trust me? What do you think I am, a spy or something?
Ah, now that's just it. I don't know what you are.
I'm sorry. Nobody else feels that way.
Oh, yes, they do.
Who else? Well, tell me, what am I supposed to have done?
I've just heard a little whisper here and there. Nothing much yet. But I'll wait until I find out more. And when I do, you'll be the first to hear about it.
Okay. So you reckon you're not with Sandy? I found a note for her today.
Oh?
Yeah, from Fitzwater. It's amazing what you find in laundry bags these days.
Anything interesting?
Yeah, you could say that. Seems they're getting a bit uptight about the number of visits the cops are making to the parlours.
Not surprised. They're their drug outlets, aren't they?
Yeah, till the cops get there. Anyhow, Fitzwater reckons there's a lagger in Wentworth who's tipping them off. And he wants Sandy to find out who it is and put a stop to it.
Well, we don't want to endanger our drug supply.
You reckon I should show the note to Sandy?
Of course not. Our first job is to see she stands no chance with Fitzwater and the women.
Go on.
I think you should write to Fitzwater. Tell him Sandy's busy. She hasn't got the time at the moment.
Now, why didn't I think of that?
B. Smith is now on kitchen duty.
So?
Well, she'll be collecting a little extra shipment in with a normal delivery. A shipment just for the women.
Shipment of what?
Extra food, goodies, does it matter? The thing is to catch her in the act.
How's it being done?
Easily enough. A few stolen requisition forms, a forged signature, and no one's the wiser.
This argument wouldn't have anything to do with me catching your stolen goods this morning, would it, Smith?
Now, why would we be arguing about that? Unless you've got a lag.
Of course she has. We know who it is, too. Well, if you ladies want to fight amongst yourselves, that's fine by me. Don't let me catch you at it, though.
Well, that's why she's walking around with only one busted arm. If anyone lags on us in here, we'll find out about it sooner or later.
What could you do?
With a lagger. Anything we want.
Surely you wouldn't do anything drastic, would you?
Listen, lagging is like fizzing on your mates outside.
Fizzing?
Dobbing your mates into the cops. Now, I'm in here for killing one of those. So work it out for yourself.
We're going to have to work out what we're going to do to Edwards before we get back to the laundry. Maybe a little accident to her face in the steam press might pull her into line.
We? Don't include me. I don't want to end up on the other end of a knife like Fitzwater. I'd rather not get involved.
Oh, you'd rather not get involved? Mm-hmm. You know, you really take the cake, do you know that?
I don't see why.
Well, I'd better refresh your memory. It was your idea to send that note to Fitzwater and sign it from Edwards. That's why our old man copped it, and that's why she killed Fitzwater.
So that's two murders you've had a hand in. You still reckon you're not involved?
Yes, but
I... No buts, lady. You play your cards right and I can be a good mate to you. The best you'll have in this dump. But with what I got on you, I could be your worst enemy. Apart from Edwards, that is. So you better make up your mind real quick which one of us you'd rather face.
See how easy it is to creep up on someone when they're asleep? Now you don't want to lie here night after night wondering when I'm going to come and get you, do you?
Good. I could have cut your throat before you'd even woken up. Now you better do as you're told. And keep your mouth shut about Dorian and the dogs. Otherwise, I'll make sure you never get a decent night's sleep again. Now, am I getting through to you? Good.
Mrs. Peterson?
I'm sorry, I was expecting someone else.
Sorry to disappoint you. I'm Ernie Ross.
Ross? Why have we been left alone?
Orders from your Inspector Grace, I suppose.
You're from the police?
God, no, do me a favour. No. I owe Grace one, and he's not the kind of guy to let anyone off the hook. I'm your witness.
Well, that is good news. Beginning to think Grace was just stringing me along.
No, he hasn't been so keen on the deal lately. He figures Fitzwater's death's liable to take the edge off things, and you're not going to be much use to him.
Oh, does he now? Well, at least you're here. What's the story going to be?
Well, Grace figures we should stick to as much of the truth as possible, so when they check us out, they don't find any loopholes.
Makes sense.
Right, well, I've got the Boulevard Motel up the Central Coast. What I figured was I'd fix the register to show that you and your boyfriend and the kid came to stay for a while. And then I'll tell them that I heard shouting and screaming coming from your unit and saw you and the little boy all cut up and bruised. If that doesn't paint a good picture, I don't know what will.
I like it. Thank you.
Sandy? Mm-hmm. Did you ever hear any more from the police about Megan Arnott?
Well, old Grace? Oh, no, he wouldn't know his bum from his ear hole. If he only knew.
Knew what?
Oh, about 6 miles out of Wedderburn, there's this old shack. On a property that used to belong to a racehorse owner or something like that. If he knew what was under the floorboards, he'd be on his way to his next promotion and I'd be doing another 20 years.
Well, what is it?
Hmm? Oh, Megan's wallet. And what is technically known as the murder weapon, with my dabs all over it.
Good grief, you're taking a risk, aren't you?
Well, he'll never find out, will he?
Hey, Kate, run down to the rec room for us, will you, love? Make sure that Mari isn't throwing her weight round. If I go down there, I'll drop the bitch.
Mm, so will I.
Well, all right. But what about the tea?
Oh, don't worry, I'll fix it. So, are you crazy? You said yourself you didn't trust her. Fancy letting that lot slip in front of her.
I don't trust her an inch. Wouldn't be at all surprised to find out she's our lager. That's why I fed her all that bull dust. If she is lagging, someone's going to be very upset with her. Very upset indeed.
We're going to have to do something to get rid of Edwards, and maybe we can keep Smith in line.
How are you going to get rid of Sandy?
With your help.
There's really nothing much I could do to help you. You'd be better off using one of your heavies. There's nothing you need me for.
Oh, yes, there is. Are you pulling out on me?
No, but my appeal's coming up soon. It's my one chance to get out of here. Please, I just want to lie low until it's all over.
And what happens if I tell Edwards what you've done to help me already? Do you reckon you'll get out of here alive then?
You wouldn't.
I would.
These tablets and things burn okay. Yes, you needn't worry about that. It seems a terrible waste. They're out of date. Most of them would probably be all right, but the hospital can't afford to take any chances.
Thank you.
goodness that lot are gone.
How long before the dope starts to take effect?
I don't know for sure. It was old stock. Should start fairly soon.
Good. I can't wait. Now, you stick close to her, and when it starts to hit, you get her into the shower block.
I can't do that. She might start to suspect something. Oh, look, I've done what you wanted. The rest is up to you.
Oh, no, you ain't finished yet. You get her into the shower block like a good little girl. You let me down, and you're next on the list.
Sandy? What's the matter?
Oh, it hurt. I've got these really bad pains in the guts, and I keep wanting to chuck.
How long has it been going on for?
Oh, just after dinner or so. It's just getting worse.
That stew must have disagreed with you. It was pretty spicy.
Oh, that kind of thing doesn't usually affect me. Maybe I'm pregnant.
Well, if you are, I don't know how you manage it in here.
Where there's a will, there's...
Look, why don't you make yourself sick? I mean, if it was something you ate, you will feel better when you've got rid of it.
No, I'm just... I'll wait, and if it doesn't pass, I'll get something from the sister.
I wouldn't advise that. She'll probably give you an emetic, and that could be pretty drastic, you know. Be less painful if you do it yourself.
I suppose I should give it a try.
No, not in there. You'll only have to clean it up. Now go to the shower block.
Look, I don't think I'm going to make the distance, all right?
Yes, of course you will. Just take it steady.
Right.
Where have you been all day?
Working in the hospital. Sandy Edwards is very much alive.
Yeah? Oh, well, you can't win them all.
You didn't tell her I had anything to do with last night, did you?
Of course not. Why should I?
You're just acting strangely towards me. So was B. You don't think they suspect anything, do you?
Look, I don't know. Just forget about it. It'll pass.
I thought you had a foolproof scheme for getting rid of Sandy. What went wrong?
It was a bloody good plan until that little bitch Doreen stuck her nose in.
What?
Yeah, she arrived just as we're hauling Edwards up.
Didn't you have a look out on the door?
Yeah, Lil, but she had to come and help me and Bev, didn't she?
Oh, I don't believe it. How could you be so stupid?
What did you say?
Why do you ignore such a simple, important detail as keeping guard?
Well, I didn't see you in on any of that heavy action.
Oh, I did my part. I got the dope, I got into the showers.
Oh, big deal, real brave stuff.
Look, I stuck my neck out for you, you stupid idiot.
Just watch who you're calling names.
But don't you realise what you've done?
Look, I'd be careful if I was you.
All Sandy and B have to do is put two and two together if they haven't already done so, and I'm gone. Oh, God, I should have known better than to trust you and your thick friends.
You're going to be sorry you said that.
Take your hands off me. You don't scare me, you brainless bag of wind.
Just who do you think you're calling names, bitch?
Leave me alone. I've got time for useless cretins like you.
Where are you?
Oh, well, what have we here?
Nothing, Mrs. Powell, just a bit of a difference, you know.
I don't know. But if there's any more of it, you'll be up on the charge.
I was just on my way to dispensary, Mrs. Powell.
Then get going.
Mind if we join you?
If you like.
What's the matter? Something wrong with the food?
Isn't there always?
You know, I've been trying to work out what made me sick the other night. What do you reckon, Doc? Do you reckon it might have been the food?
Possible, I suppose. Though I don't see why the rest of us weren't affected.
Yeah. I suppose if I had a suspicious mind, I might think someone was trying to have a go at me.
What? Put something in your food? Really, Sandra, you surprise me.
Yeah. I mean, where would they get the stuff? All that kind of thing's kept in the hospital.
Look, I'm not going to beat around the bush. I've just heard a very serious rumour from one of the prisoners, and I want a straight answer from you.
Well, of course, I'll do what I can to help. That's the trouble in here, you know. There's not enough corroboration.
Forget it, Peterson. I am not Mrs. Powell. Now, you've been accused of two things. Informing to the police and lagging to prison officers. Now, is this true or false?
That's ridiculous. Where on earth did you hear that?
It's not important. What is important is that you tell me the truth.
But I am Mrs. Morris. It's absolutely absurd.
I hope so.
Look, I don't understand. I thought prisoners were encouraged to help the staff.
There is a huge difference between helping and telling tales, Peterson.
Now, you've seen how violent these women can get. So there's no need for me to tell you what they would do to an informer. If someone gets caught lagging, they get hurt, and hurt very badly. Now, for your own sake, if you've got something to say, say it to me now. Very well. I can't force you. Get ready for lunch.
You gave me a fright.
Yeah, you look a bit jumpy. Maybe you should get a nerve tonic. Shouldn't be hard for you to get something from the hospital, should it? Didn't see you at the exercise period. You missed a lot of fun.
Would it be best if I stayed away from the women? Seems someone's spreading rumors about me.
Oh, God, people are funny buggers, aren't they? You know, someone was actually trying to tell me that one of my friends was a lagger. I mean, how thick do they think I am? One of my friends a lagger? Oh, God, they'd have to be pretty stupid. Unless they really wanted to make me angry. What do you reckon, Doc? Do you reckon anyone would be that stupid?
Sister Franklin? Yes, Miss Sharp. No, I'm afraid I can't. I'm supposed to have left here an hour ago. Well, when did it happen? Any swelling? Oh, why didn't you say that in the first place? All right, I'll be there in a minute.
I give up. A sprained ankle in D block.
Oh, I'll never get home. Take that into Edwards for me, would you?
But I can't. I'm not allowed. Make you feel better.
Looks like you could deal with it yourself.
Oh?
Hmm. That's a bad case of the shakes you've got there.
What?
The shakes.
Well, as I said before, Sister Franklin isn't the easiest person to get along with.
Hmm. No, I couldn't. You'll have it. You could deal with it.
Oh, don't be silly. Sister Franklin might come in.
Well, she can get her own. Drink it.
But it's for headaches, not nerves.
Drink it.
Oh, no. You'll be back so soon.
False alarm. Now perhaps I can get away from this place.
I think you ought to look at Sandy. She's acting rather strangely.
Oh, what's wrong?
Well, I think you should look, sister. I've been reminded before. I'm just a prisoner here.
All right. You sound as if it's serious.
Yes, I think it is.
Seems quite peaceful at the moment. I'll check on her again after I finish this. What exactly did...
Oh, never mind, I'll not want for long. You get the plates, I'll get the knives and forks.
Oh, watch it, will you?
It's the matter now, you like the company. Where are you going, Peterson?
I'm sorry, Mrs. Morris, I'm not feeling very well. I took one look at the food and I'm sorry, I've got to go. Oh.
Thank you.
won't take long. Just the discharge forms to fill in and then you can go to dinner.
Where's Kate?
Oh, she left as soon as the bell went. Flew out of here as if her life depended on it. She must have been very hungry considering what they serve up in this place. How do you cope with it?
Oh, you get used to it.
Yeah, I guess that's true about everything, really.
Sorry, didn't mean to interrupt you. I heard you're not feeling too good.
Just resting, that's all.
Yeah, don't look well. Must have been something you ate. Or drank.
I'm just resting. Besides, with the way people have been acting lately, I'd rather be on my own.
Is that why you missed dinner?
No, I just wasn't hungry.
Good morning, Mrs. Peterson.
Mr. Andrews.
I believe we're entitled to a private interview.
Of course.
Right now, I think I've got some good news for you.
I'm very glad to hear it. My last solicitor would have choked if he'd had to say something like that.
Yes, well, I know nothing of that.
So, what is this good news?
Simply that I believe we can have your sentence reduced from murder to manslaughter. It's quite a step, and one that would have been impossible without the evidence of Mr. Ross.
Well, he wasn't easy to find.
Yes, so I gather. But with his testimony, a little legal expertise, and taking into account the time you've already served, I think we can have you out of here in 6 months.
That, Mr. Andrews, is a marked improvement on 12 years.
Yes, of course. But I don't want to build you up with mere hopes. Our whole success depends on the testimony of Mr. Ross. Now, it was at his motor lodge that your lover, Conrad, made repeated threats and attacks against you and your son.
Yes, that's correct. Of course, I wasn't aware at the time that anybody overheard. I never thought I'd be grateful for motel rooms having such thin walls.
Yes, of course. This Mr. Ross is an excellent witness. Why wasn't he called to the original trial?
Well, as I said before, Mr. Andrews, he wasn't easy to find, and my original lawyer left a lot to be desired.
I see.
But with you in charge, I'm sure I can look forward to getting out of here very soon.
Lost your appetite? You're not eating enough. You've got to keep your strength up.
I've had enough, and it's rubbish anyway.
Well, that depends on what you do. I mean, you can spice it up a bit. Here, you try some of this. More to your taste, I think.
I'm sick and tired of your infantile little games. All I care, you can rot in your own stupidity, and believe me, there's enough of that to go around. Thank God I don't have to put up with you for much longer.
I mean, you've helped me adjust to this place. I'm grateful. You could help me a lot more if you took care of Sandy Edwards for me. Go on. You could have her transferred to isolation.
Peterson, you do have a heart. At the very least, I thought you'd want me to have her lynched.
You could do with the money, couldn't you?
Forget it. In the first place, it's an offence. In the second, do you really think I would be stupid enough to accept money from a prisoner?
Think about it. More money than you could earn in a lifetime.
Mrs. Powell?
What is it? I was wondering if anybody is to be moved into my dormitory with me.
Probably. Why?
I'm enjoying my privacy. I'd like to keep it that way.
Well, you're occupying a three-bed dorm. You can't expect to have it all to yourself.
And I'd like to be moved to a single cell.
Whereabouts? The Hilton?
Why not? I can afford it. You have been thinking about what I said, haven't you?
Who is my visitor?
Someone you're quite familiar with by now. No, not that way. The visit, it's to be held in the governor's office.
Why the governor's office?
Well, why not? Nothing but the best for our Dr. Peterson. Come on.
What's going on? Mr. Davidson?
Inspector Grace will explain.
What am I doing here?
Well, now, you're going to be charged with fraud, Mrs. Peterson. Conspiring to import drugs into the prison. Conspiring to pervert the course of justice. And now attempted bribery of a prison officer, it seems.
You're mad. I don't have to stay here and listen to
You don't have to answer any of these charges, but I must warn you that anything you say may be taken down, reduced to type, and may be used in evidence against you.
Well, you'll have to get your evidence from somewhere else, won't you? Because you haven't got any. You can't prove any of these charges.
What's he writing down?
Oh, that's Detective Sergeant Ross. He's just doing his job.
Detective? What are you trying to do to me? You've all had a hand in this, haven't you? The attempted bribery of an officer. Sounds cheap and dirty, doesn't it? Insulting. But I seem to remember you were eager enough at the time. What happened, pal? Get cold feet.
Come on, Mrs. Peterson. You've been supplying us with enough evidence yourself, don't you think? I mean, there's your attempt to rig a crooked witness and your secret accounts and now bribery of a prison officer. You're going to be in here for a long time.
Oh, no. You used me. You used my information. You can't keep me in here. You pig, you used
it! Come on! Peterson, come on!
Nobody uses me!
Well, just to show I'm not resentful, I won't add assault of a police officer to the charges.
Peterson, you will be placed in solitary confinement.
I'll go with you.
Right. Kill you!
Join the queue, lady. There's a waiting list.
You can't keep me in here forever. I'll kill you, all of you. You're all liars and cheaters, filthy!
What's up with you? You wanted to know why the dope I promised you didn't come off.
Did you find out?
Yeah. Our good friend Peterson's been trading information with the cops.
What? What? She means she's...
Keep it down, will you? She's been trading information in return for favours all along. And she gave my letter for the mob to a bloody cop.
Jeez, Mary, what you gonna do?
What do you reckon? I'm gonna do that, bitch.
We'll be in on that, yeah. Right?
Superstitious.
I hope not.
Looks like your lucky day. When?
I'll let you know.
I reckon you earned that one. Just make sure you collect your winnings real soon.
Mrs. Powell!
What do you want?
Now, do you believe me?
What's all this about?
Sandy Edwards gave that to me last night after she finished playing some sort of game with Mari Winter.
And you think it's a threat?
It's the death card.
Oh, that's a bit melodramatic, isn't it? You say Sandy's threatening to kill you?
They all are.
What do you think, Meg? Well, if the threat is real...
It is.
I think perhaps a shift to isolation.
Perhaps. But then if they are all out to get her, I wonder she wouldn't be in danger for B. Smith as well. You must be in the running for Wentworth's Most Unpopular Girl Award. You don't know who hates you most.
It's not a joke.
I couldn't agree more. Now go and get dressed. Report to the laundry after breakfast.
I think it's about time we sorted out our differences.
Yeah, I reckon it's about time.
I don't know what you mean.
Oh, come on, you must know.
What do you want?
I just want to have a little chat with you in private.
You've had plenty of opportunity for that.
I needed time to think about it. And there never was a moment that was quite private enough. Now, Mari and I figure that being a nice day, most of the women are going to be out in the garden for their exercise period. So we want to meet you in the shower block.
Both of you?
Mari's just coming along to make sure there's no funny business. You know. So you be there. And we'll be waiting.
What do you reckon?
No worries. She'll be in the garden.
You stay away from me or I'll yell for the officers.
That wouldn't be very nice, would it?
What are you up to?
I just thought we might have our little chat. You were supposed to meet me in the shower block.
What's going on here?
Oh, Kate just upset the rubbish bin. I was going to help her clean it up.
That's not true.
Okay. It's nothing to get upset about.
But I didn't...
I don't care who knocked them over. You can both pick it up. This bin shouldn't be here anyway. The garbage truck's due any minute now, so when you get that lot cleaned up, you can take the bins round to the dump.
Okay. I'm not going anywhere with her.
Don't be ridiculous, Peterson. You'll do as you're told. I'll be there to see that you do.
This is intolerable.
Oh, stop whinging. You're better off carrying the bloody bin than being inside it.
Why don't you both save your breath? I'd like to see this garbage going out this week.
You must love this, getting women to do your dirty work.
Keep your comments to yourself, Peterson.
No!
Ready for our little chat, Ben?
Hold it. Edwards and Peterson are missing.
Maybe they went for a walk.
Where's Edwards?
I don't know.
You were with her.
You tell everyone to come inside. I just followed.
I'll find her.
Okay. Righto, the rest of you, back to work.
What?
I don't know. I was just getting rid of the rubbish. What do you want?
You and Edwards set me up.
Would have thought it was the other way around.
Well, that's something that ain't finished yet. But right now, I want to know where Edwards is. Did she have an escape plan?
How should I know?
Hazel Kent knows all about it.
Well, ask Hazel.
I'm asking you.
Look, I told Mrs. Davidson, I heard the fight, and I turned around to see what was going on. When I looked back, Sandy had gone.
Well, that story might be good enough for Davo, but I'm not buying it. You knew Edwards and me was after you. You wouldn't have taken your eyes off her for a second.
I don't know anything. Sandy wouldn't tell me anything.
You'd say anything to save your neck. You always have.
I tell you, I don't know anything.
What's going on here?
Just having a little chat, Mr. Faulkner.
Get back to your own cell. It's almost lock-up time.
There's still 15 minutes left yet.
Get back to your cell. I want a few words with Peterson.
Oh, right. With Edwards out of the way, you're going to have to find yourself a new lover, aren't you?
Where's Edwards?
Not another one. I don't know.
Then what were you talking to Winter about?
Look, if I tell you, I'm going to need protection.
I'll lock you in your cell.
That's fine for tonight. What about tomorrow?
I'll speak to the governor. We'll keep an eye on you.
That little good that'll do.
It's better than nothing.
Sandy planned the escape all along. The fight was merely a diversion to keep you occupied. Mari and the rest of them were all in it too. That's why Mari was here, threatening me to keep my mouth shut.
But you're telling me anyway.
What have I got to lose? She's going to kill me. Keeping my mouth shut won't change that.